乌俄战争再度升级，拜登政府在先前批准乌克兰使用美制飞弹来打击俄罗斯本土之后，乌克兰在昨天马上就发射了六枚飞弹，对俄罗斯西部的布扬斯克州来进行攻击，而且这也让俄国外长最新表示，战争已经进入了新阶段，将会做出回应。
就在乌俄战争的第1000天，乌克兰首次越境发动美制陆军战术飞弹系统 ATACMS， 挑战普廷底线。六枚飞弹瞄准俄罗斯领土布扬斯克，根据俄方消息，其中一枚飞弹碎片甚至击中当地军火库，酿起火灾。
ATACMS are a surface-to-surface missile system fired from a mobile launcher vehicle. They can strike up to 190 miles away.Well behind Russian lines. In November, President Biden finally gave Ukraine the green light.
为了回应拜登允许乌克兰使用美制武器攻击俄罗斯领土，普廷也已经下修核武使用门槛。现在，即使是无核国家，只要有受到任何有核武国家的支持，并对俄罗斯发动攻击，莫斯科当局便可以考虑动用核武。
If long-range missiles are going to be applied.From Ukraine into Russian territory, and we will be taking this as a qualitatively new phase of the Western war against Russia, and we'll react accordingly.
Putin would possibly risk a nuclear escalation in extreme circumstances, for sure. But you know, Ukraine striking a few targets on Russian territory would probably not constitute that. Trying to sway the West, to convince the West to influence its support for Ukraine, to break it up, especially now in this very vulnerable moment.
专家指出，普廷此举是想要挑拨西方和乌克兰关系。对此，美方也淡定表示，并不惊讶。
Not surprised by the comments the Kremlin has made around the publication of this new revised nuclear doctrine. We have not seen any reason to adjust our own nuclear posture.
欧盟多国连同美国再度重申会支持乌克兰，但与此同时，北欧国家包含瑞典、芬兰等都已经发布新版民防手册，要当地公民随时保持警觉，为最坏的情况做好准备。记者庄心莲、邓邦冠综合报道。